الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على السلام
الكريم الأحد الصمد الذي لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. نحمده سبحانه وتعالى ونتوب إليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له تعظيما لشأنه، وأشهد أن محمدا صلى الله عليه وسلم عبده ورسوله داعي إلى رضوانه. أما بعد، أحبتي في الله أيها المسلمون الكرام، أوصيكم نفسي بتقوى الله عز وجل. يقول الله تبارك وتعالى في كتابه بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. All thanks and praises due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Lord of the universe. We thank Him. We glorify Him day and then. And as Muslims, we do testify that there is none worthy of worship and praise except Allah and Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the final and seal of all prophets and messengers Allah sent to guide myself and all of you and the entire mankind from the darkness of disobedience, darkness towards the nur of Islam and light. I pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us be amongst the guided ones, Kareem. Respectable brothers, fathers, mothers and sisters in the deen, I want to take this opportunity to advise myself, first of all, and admonish you to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah says in the Quran, calling you and myself, He said, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, O you who believe, ittaqullah, fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, haqqa tuqati, as he ought to be feared, wa la tamutunna illa wa antum muslimun, and do not die except in the state of Islam. Inna min akbar ni'am, أنعمها الله سبحانه وتعالى علينا هي نعمة الإسلام. The greatest نعمة favor Allah has ever bestowed upon you and myself is submission to Him, to accept the deen, to be a Muslim. The Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, قَدْ أَفْلَحَ مَنْ أَسْلَمْ. Successful is the one who accepted Islam. وَرُزِقَ كَفَافًا. And he or she has been provided with satisfaction. وَقَنَّعَهُ اللَّهُ بِمَا آتَاهُ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give them contentment. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us be amongst those categories, Ya Kareem. And Allah said, وَمَنْ أَحْسَنُ قَوْلًا مِمَّنْ دَعَى إِلَى اللَّهِ. He said, who is best in speech than the one who called to the path of Allah, وَعَمِلَ الصَّالِحَ, and they do righteous deeds. وَقَالَ, and the person will say, إِنَّنِي مِنَ الْمُسْلِمِينَ. And he will say, I am a Muslim. Therefore, my dear brothers and sisters in the deen, نَحْنُ فِي أَوَّلْ أَيَّامْ رَمَضَانْ. We are in the first days of the month of Ramadan. The first days of the month of Ramadan. The month of blessing. The month of mercy. The month of forgiveness. The month of charity. The month of Quran. The month in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed myself and all of you with Laylatul Qadr, the night of power. Al-insan bitabi'ati, man by nature, yukhti laylan wa nahara. We are prone to mistakes. We make mistakes in the night and in the day. That's human being. Sometimes we do things because of forgetfulness. Sumi al-insan bikathrati nisyani. Man is called in Arabic insan because of forgetfulness. You forget. And it's a blessing as well to forget. Because if all the problems you have in your mind stays there, it doesn't go, you don't forget it at all, and it accumulates, it might even drive you mad within an hour or less than that. So it's a blessing from Allah to forget sometimes. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide us to the path. So therefore we make mistakes all the time. That's what Allah said in the Quran. He said, وَلَوْ يُؤَاخِذُ اللَّهُ النَّاسَ بِذُلْمِهِمْ مَا تَرَكَ عَلَى ذَهْرِهَا مِنْ دَابَّةٍ. If Allah was to arrest man, if Allah was to arrest me and you because of our sins, Allah said He wouldn't have left any creature, any man, any human being on the surface of the earth. Wallahi. He said, وَلَكِنْ يُؤَخِّرُهُمْ إِلَىٰ أَجَلٍ مُسَمَّى. But Allah gives you respite so that you will turn to Him and repent until a particular time, an appointed time. But when the time comes, Allah said, فَإِذَا جَاءَ أَجَلُهَا أَجَلُهُمْ. He said, but when the moment comes for them to meet me, for them to depart this world, لَا يَسْتَأْخِرُونَ السَّاعَةَ وَلَا يَسْتَقْدِمُونَ. No delay. Allah will not delay. And we will not rush. Once the time is up, there will be no delay. So be prepared for that day. Because of that, the mercy of Allah, that's why He gave us the month of Ramadan. Allah said, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu. Said, O you who believe, kutiba alaykum as-siyam. Fasting is prescribed to you, obligatory upon you to fast. كما كتب على الذين من قبلكم, as it was ordained to those before you, لعلكم تتقون, so that you may become God conscious people, to become متقين, piety, to gain that piety, God consciousness. أيام معدودات. Fasting is for prescribed number of days. فَمَنْ كَانَ مِنْكُمْ مَرِيدًا. Whoever amongst you is sick, أو على سفر, or they are on a journey, فعدة من أيام أخر. They must make up for the days that they miss. وعلى الذين يطيقونه فدية طعام مسكين. And for those who cannot fast at all, like the pregnant women, breastfeeding women, or those who have chronic disease and they are unable to fast, Allah said, you feed a miskin every day. فَمَنْ تَتَوَّى خَيْرًا فَهُوَ خَيْرُ اللَّهِ. Anyone who give more, that's good for them. وَأَنْ تَسُومُوا خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ. But for you to fast is better for you. إِنْ كُنْتُمْ تَعْلَمُونَ. If you know. So therefore, my dear brothers and sisters, Allah does not want to punish you. Fasting in the Ramadan, it's not about you feeling the thirst. It's not about you feeling hunger, become hungry. No. The purpose of fasting, Allah said, لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ, so that you become piety. لِأَنَّ رَمَضَانَ مَعْهَدْ. Ramadan is an institution. You have entered into the institution as a layman. A man that needs to be moved. A man that is he needs to have that good character, good ways of dealing with people and your brothers and sisters around you. And the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned that in the hadith. According to Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu, he said, as qala Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the Messenger of Allah, may the peace and blessings of Allah be upon him, said. قال الله عز وجل. Allah said in the Hadith Qudsi, your Lord, your Creator said, كل عمل ابن آدم لا. He said, every act of the son of Adam, every act of worship of the son of Adam, لا, is for him. Your salah is for you. Your zakah is for you, and etc. Allah said, every act of worship you do, la, is for you. Illa sawm, except fasting. Allah said, fasting is not for you. Illa sawm, except fasting. فَإِنَّهُ لِي. Allah said, it is for me. وَأَنَا أَجْزِي بِي. And I will be the one to reward you. And the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam continued, he said, وَالصِّيَامُ جُنَّةٌ. Fasting is a shield. Fasting is a shield. فَإِذَا كَانَ يَوْمُ صَوْمِ أَحَدِكُمْ فَلَا يَرْفُثُ وَلَا يَسْخُثُ. He said, when one is observing fast, he should not indulge in obscene languages. You should not swear, curse, don't do it. That's what the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tells you here, Allah says. He said, فَلَا يَرْفُثُ. You must not indulge in obscene language. وَلَا يَسْخُثُ. And you must not raise your voice shouting. Don't do that. And then he said, فَإِن سَابَهُ أَحَدٌ أَوْ قَاتَلَهُ. If one comes to you, swear at you, or wants to fight you, don't do it. Say, فَلْيَقُلْ. The person has to say, إِنِّي صَائِمٌ. I am fasting. I'm not going to fight you. I'm not going to swear at you. But mind you, don't say to the person, don't worry. Now I'm fasting. Wait when I break my fast. La ilaha. Fasting is not just in the day. Because the whole month of Ramadan is sacred. Brothers and sisters are doing it, they are saying it. You wait. Immediately when I break my fast, I will show you. Then what fast are you observing? May Allah guide us to the sweet path. And then the Rasul said, he said, وَالَّذِي نَفْسُ مُحَمَّدٍ بِيَدِي. He said, by the one in whose hands the soul of Muhammad is, Allah is it. He said, لَخَلُوفُ فَمِّ سَوَئِمْ أَطْيَبُ عِنْدُ اللَّهِ مِنْ رِيحِ الْمِسْكِ. He said, the breath of the one who is observing the fast is sweeter to Allah than the fragrance of the mosque. Subhanak ya Rabbi. What comes out the breath of the sun to Allah is sweeter than the fragrance of the what? The mosque perfume. Brothers and sisters, and the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said on the authority of Bukhari, he said, من لم يدع قول سور ولا عمل به. He said, he who does not abstain from false statements, telling lies, fabricating things while they are fasting, and then they abstain from doing evil acts, he said, then the person has to know that فليس لله حاجة. Allah has no need in his fasting. في أن يدع طعامه وشرابه. Then it's better for him to just eat and drink. Because when one is fasting, you talk about your brothers and sisters, you backbiting them, you're eating their flesh. Allah said, وَلَا يَغْتَبْ بَعْدُكُمْ بَعْدًا. None of you should backbite one another. أَيُحِبُّ أَحَدُكُمْ أَن يَأْكُلَ لَحْمَ أَخِيهِ مَيُّتًا فَكَرِهْتُمُ. Do any one of you like to eat the raw meat of their dead brother or sister? Never. You would dislike that. So abstain from all this. So Ramadan is there to pave my character and your character. لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. To put a demarcation between you and what Allah dislike. What Allah has made haram. When you are fasting, you become kind to your brothers and sisters. You become respectful. You don't swear. So when Ramadan finishes, you become a graduate from the institution of Ramadan. You become a perfect man. You become that man who was possessed or obtained certain character that will make you be amongst the best of the best. Listen to this beautiful hadith. The Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, he said, إذا كان أول ليلة من شهر رمضان, the first day of the month of Ramadan, when the moon appears, when the Ramadan appeared to me and you, when the Ramadan comes, the first day, سُفِّدَتْ الشَّيَاطِينَ, all the shaitan are being chained. Shaitan is chained right now. And not only that, وَمَرَدَتُ الْجِنِّ, and all the evil ones amongst the jinn. وَغُلِّقَتْ أَبْوَابُ النَّارِ, and the doors of the hellfire are closed. Allah. The doors of the hellfire are closed right now as I'm speaking to you. فَلَمْ يُفْتَحْ مِنْهَا بَابٌ, no door of the doors of the hellfire will be open. وَفُتِحَتْ أَبْوَابُ الْجَنَّةِ, and the doors of paradise are open. All the eight doors are open. Do you know what that means? وَلَمْ يُغْلَقْ مِنْهَا بَابٌ, no door amongst the door of the doors of Jannah will be closed. I ask a question. Do you know what that means? It means that these doors are now open for you. It's left with you now to choose which door of those eight doors you will go through. We have Babu Salah, the door of prayers. Babu Zakah, the door of charity. Babu Siyam, the door of fasting. Babu Rayyan. So you choose all the doors, Sadaqah, and etc. Which door you want to use to enter Jannah? فَيُنَادِ مُنَادٍ, a caller is calling upon me and you, all of you, saying, يَا بَاغِيَ الْخَيْرِ أَقْبِلْ, oh, you the one who aim at the good, come forward, hasten, وَسَارِعُوا إِلَى مَغْفِرَةٍ مِّ رَبِّكُمْ. Allah said, hasten to the forgiveness of your Lord. وَجَنَّةٍ عَرْضُهَا السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَعِدَّةٍ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. Paradise, the weeds of paradise. Skies above and the earth below is being prepared for those who are God conscious. Yunadi Munadi, a caller is calling. You say, Ya Baghi al Khair, oh, you the one who am at the good, oh, you the one who wants Al Jannah, Aqbil. Come forward. Don't delay. Don't be relent. Wa Ya Baghi al Shar, oh, you the one who am at the good. أصر أبستين reduce the evil and that continues until the end of Ramadan. You see how merciful Allah is. Allah does not want to punish you. The same ayah I mentioned earlier, when Allah said, وَلَوْ يُؤَخِذُ اللَّهُ النَّاسَ بِذُلْمِهِمْ مَا تَرَكَ عَلَيْهَا مِنْ دَابَ. If Allah was to arrest you because of your sins, by now you would have been dead or destroyed. But He does not want to punish you. He gave myself and all of you Ramadan. Now the opportunity is in your hands. Because Ramadan, شهر التوبة, the month of forgiveness, seeking forgiveness. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said, قُلْ يَا عِبَادِيَ الَّذِينَ أَسْرَفُوا عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ. Said, Sir, O ye my servants, who have wronged your souls, you oppressed yourselves. Since the last year Ramadan to now, you've made mistakes. You've committed sins. You're not perfect, I'm not perfect. Because the Rasulullah said, كُلُّ ابْنَ آدَمْ خَطَّاءٌ. Every man makes mistake. وَخَيْرُ خَطَّائِينَ التَّوَّابُونَ. The best amongst you are those after they've committed sin, they turn to Allah in repentance, asking Him, Allah forgive us. So Allah is calling you. He said, قُلْ يَا عِبَادِيَ الَّذِينَ أَسْرَفُوا عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ. He said, say, O you my servants who have wronged your souls, لَا تَقْنَتُوا مِنْ رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ. Do not lose hope from Allah's mercy. Whatever sins you have committed. Now, brothers and sisters, do not lose hope from Allah's mercy. Why? إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ جَمِيعًا. Allah forgive all sins. Whatever sins you have committed. Allah said, يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ جَمِيعًا. Allah forgive all sins. إِنَّهُ. Because He, Allah, هُوَ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. He is of forgiven and the most merciful. Allah said, نَبِّ عِبَادِي. Tell my servants. Inform them, tell them that أَنِّي أَنَا الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. That I, Allah, am the oft forgiven and the most merciful. But at the same time, وَأَنَّ عَذَابِي هُوَ الْعَذَابُ الْأَلِيمُ. But my punishment as well is severe. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive each and every one of us. أقول قولي هذا أستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المؤمنين فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. Alhamdulillah, wassalatu wassalam ala Rasulullah. We thank Allah and the peace and blessings be upon the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. My dear respectable brothers and sisters, as a human being, a servant of Allah, don't lose hope from the mercy of Allah. He forgives. Don't say, I've committed too many sins. Allah will not forgive me. Having that thought, it's sin by itself. Your Lord is a forgiving God. Once you do tawbah and nasuha, sincere repentance, then Allah is always in position to forgive you. What you need to do is أن تكون بين الخوف والرجاء. You have to fear between fear and hope. You fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His punishment. At the same time, you hope He's forgive for His mercy and forgiveness. And that's why the Rasulullah said, He said, Man sama Ramadan, anyone who fasts in the month of Ramadan, وَمَنْ قَامَ رَمَضَانَ. He said, anyone who stand in the month of Ramadan in prayers, وَمَنْ قَامَ لَيْلَةَ الْقَدْرِ. Anyone who stand in the night of power in worship, إِيمَانًا, out of true faith, وَاحْتِسَابًا, and you do not hope from anyone to reward you except Allah. The Rasul said, غُفِرَ لَهُ مَا تَقَدَّمَ مِنْ ذَنْبِ. Allah will forgive all the sins you've committed all the past year. رمضان إلى رمضان وكفرات أو كفارة فيما بينهما. In between each Ramadan is expiation of sins. Listen to this beautiful hadith Qudsi. According to Anas radiallahu anhu, he said that the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam reported about his Lord saying, he said, Yabna Adam, Allah said, O you the son of Adam. He said, Innaka ma da'awtani. He said, for as long as you call me, for as long as you call me, as long as you call upon me, Allah, he said, wa raja'utani. And also as well, you hope for my forgiveness. غَفَرْتُ لَكَ. Allah said, I will forgive you. مَا كَانَ مِنْكَ. Whatever sin you commit. As long as you call Allah and you hope for His forgiveness, Allah said, He will forgive you. It does not matter whatever sin you have committed. Subhanak. He said, وَلَا أُبَالِي. Allah said, I don't care. I will still forgive you. يَبْنَ آدَمْ. O you the son of Adam. لَوْ بَلَغَتْ ذُنُوبُكَ عَنَانَ السَّمَاءِ. He said, if your sins reach the height of the seven skies above, you commit sin. This Allah talking to you now. Allah said, وَلَوْ بَلَغَتْ ذُنُوبُكَ عَنَانَ السَّمَاءِ. If your sins that you've committed reach the height of the skies above, he said, ثُمَّ اسْتَغْفَرْتَنِي. Then you ask me for my forgiveness. Allah said, غَفَرْتُ لَكَ. I will still forgive you. Subhanak, Ya Rabbi. What a forgiving God. I will still forgive you, he said. يَبْنَ آدَمْ. O you the son of Adam. إِنَّكَ لَوْ أَتَيْتَنِي بِقُرَابِ الْأَرْضِ خَطَايَا. Allah said, if you come to me, you meet me with an earth load of sins. This earth full of sins. Allah said, he said, ثُمَّ لَقَيْتَنِي. And you meet me. لَا تُشْرِكْ بِي شَيْئًا. Without associating me with a partner. He said, لَأَتَيْتُكَ بِقُرَابِهَا مَغْفِرَةً. He said, I will come to you. I will meet you equivalent to that with forgiveness. Akhil Kareem. So do not relent. It's just 4 weeks. Don't relent from standing in the night. Because Ramadan, Shahr al-Qiyam, you stand in the night asking Allah forgiveness. Shahr al-Quran. Accompany the Quran. Shahr Ramadan, the month of Ramadan, الذي أنزل فيه القرآن, in which the Quran was revealed, hudan lin-nas, its guidance for mankind, وبينات من الهدى والفرقان, and a clear criterion for myself and all of you. اقرأوا القرآن. The Rasul said, read the Quran. صلى الله عليه وسلم. He said, read the Quran. Why? فإنه يأتي يوم القيامة شفيعا لأصحابه. The Quran will come the day of judgment as a human, intercede on your behalf to Allah. The Quran, the ones that you put in your shelves, you don't read them. And please, before we go, 2 very important things. Your salah. What's the use fasting in Ramadan? And we don't observe our salah or observe them on time. Don't joke with your salah. أول ما يحاسب به العبد يوم القيامة صلاته. Your first question between you and Allah, the day of judgment, is your prayer. If Allah accepts your salah, then Allah will accept all the other acts. But if your salah is not being accepted, all the deeds that you do, all the acts, will go in vain. Finally, Ramadan, شهر الصدقة. Ramadan is the month of charity. Aina antum? Where are you from sadaqah? This is the month you need to spend for Allah. This is the month you need to buy so many gifts or give iftar sa'im to give the poor, feed the one who fasts. Because when you feed the person who fasts, you have the same reward as them without their reward being reduced. Here in the masjid, alhamdulillah, we spend 300 to 400, 500 pounds every single day for iftar. Alhamdulillah. We ask my brothers and sisters to come on board, because this is an opportunity. Imagine you feeding 200, 300 people every single day. And in this month, the number is getting doubled. Why? Because we have guestless sheikhs that come from Saudi and etc. They're here with us. So it's a blessing for myself and all of you. Don't relent. Spend for the sake of Allah. We need your charity. Whatever you give, فَلِيَنْفُسِكُمْ, is for yourself. It's for yourself. When they say to you, فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ, thank the brothers and sisters who pledged to you to give sadaqah. Don't say, that masjid or that brother or that sister, they are too much every day sadaqah, sadaqah. You should be praying for them. You should be asking Allah to give them the best of this dunya and the hereafter. Why? Because they're holding your hand towards the right path. May Allah forgive each and every one of us. Those who are sick, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shifa. And may Allah accept our Ramadan. May Allah make us be amongst those whose sins will be expiated and forgiven this world until the day of judgment. Before I go, please, we are asking you, the brothers and sisters are around. We want brothers. We are falling short of the expenditure that we have to spend in the month of Ramadan. Allah. We are. We just want, if you can pledge £300 to feed the whole day over 200-300 people, we have the forms around. Put your name. The bank account is there. You can pay it. It's very quick, brothers. The money you left, you put in your bank account. Subhanak, ya Rabbi. That money is not yours, you know. That's what the Rasulullah said. It's the money of your inheritance. Once you die, they won't even take anything from there. They want to hold it. All the properties you leave behind you, it's not for you. It's for your inheritance. But what you've eaten, what you spend for the sake of Allah, hadha maluk, this is your own wealth. It's your own money, because it's been kept for you to Allah. So if we are going, ask. If you have the cash, you give. If it's £100 you want to give, give. If £50, but make it clear to brothers and sisters who are out there, say this is for Ramadan. So they will put it separately. We make sure we use it for its purpose. Allahumma aghfir lana warhamna. واستر وعفو عنا وتجاوز عن سيئاتنا وتوفنا مع الأبرار. اللهم نسألك توبة نصوحة. اللهم نسألك توبة نصوحة. اللهم تقبل صيامنا وقيامنا وركوعنا وسجودنا ودعاءنا. اللهم ادخلنا الجنة مع الأبرار. ربنا لا تجعل لنا ذنبا إلا غفرت، ولا عيبا إلا سترت، ولا هما إلا فردت، ولا دينا إلا قضيت، ولا مريدا إلا شفيت، ولا ضال منا إلا هديت. نسألك يا الله أن ترفع مكتك وغضبك عنا، ولا تؤاخذنا بما فعلنا يا الله، ولا تؤاخذنا بما فعل سفهاء منا برحمتك يا رحمن الرحمين. اللهم اغفر لنا ولوالدينا وللمسلمين والمسلمات برحمتك يا رحمن الرحمين. اللهم انصر المؤمنين والمؤمنات، اللهم انصرهم في كل أنحاء العالم يا الله. اللهم انصرنا على القوم الكافرين، اللهم انصرنا على القوم الكافرين. اللهم ثبتنا وثبت أقدامنا وانصرنا على القوم الظالمين. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. وصلي اللهم على سيدنا محمد وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين. قوموا إلى صلاتكم يرحمكم الله.